Welcome to a lesson on solving for unknown values using the triangle proportionality theorem, which we proved in the previous video. Let's go ahead and review the theorem. If a parallel line to one side of a triangle intersects the two other sides, this would be the parallel line that intersects the two sides, then it divides those sides proportionally. And as you can see, I listed six different proportions that are true, which is a result of either this theorem or that the small triangle and the large triangle are similar. So you may want to pause the video to review these. We're going to go and take a look at our examples. So in this problem, notice that segment BE is parallel to segment CD, and we want to determine the length of segment BC, so let's go ahead and label this with an X here. So this example is pretty straightforward. This parallel line cuts these two sides of the triangle so that the segments are proportional, which means that x to 12 would be equal to 10 to 15. So now to solve for x, we can cross multiply. 15 times x would be 15x, must equal 12 times 10, that's 120. Now we'll divide both sides by 15. So we have x equals 120 divided by 15 equals 8. So the length of BC is equal to 8 units. Now let's go and take a look at a second example that's a little bit more involved. Again, here we see that segment AB is parallel to segment ED, and we're asked to find the length of AC, the length of BD, the length of DC, and the length of DE. Well, the length of AC would be the length of this long segment here. So the length of AC would just be 18 units plus 27 units, which is equal to 45 units. Now these next three will take a little bit more work. In order to find the length of BD, I'm going to go ahead and label it X. We can set up a proportion comparing BD to BC and AE to AC. So we'll have X to 36 must be equal to 18 to, remember, AC was 45. And now again, we'll cross multiply. So we have x times 45, that's 45x, must equal 36 times 18, which is 648. Now we'll divide both sides by 45. And I went ahead and used a calculator, that's going to be 14.4 units. So the length of BD is 14.4. Now to determine the length of DC, we have a couple options here. Let's go ahead and use the length of BD, which we just found is 14.4. So 14.4 to Y must equal 18 to 27. Again, we'll cross multiply. 18 times Y would be 18Y, must equal 14.4 times 27. That's going to give us 388.8. And now we'll divide both sides by 18. And Y is equal to 21.6. Therefore, the length of DC is equal to 21.6 units. Now, I do want to mention this is not the only proportion that we could use to determine the length of DC, which we labeled Y. We could have used a proportion Y to 36 must equal 27 to AC, which is 45. And the result, of course, would be the same. The last length we need to determine is the length of DE, which is the length of this parallel segment. Let's go ahead and call it Z. Let's go ahead and call it Z. And this small triangle and this large triangle are actually similar triangles, which means their sides are proportional. So we could use the proportion Z to 28 must equal 27 to AC, which was 45 units. And again, now we'll cross multiply. 45Z must equal 28 times 27, which is equal to 756. And we'll divide both sides by 45. Divided by 45 is 16.8. So the length of DE is 16.8 units. And that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found these examples helpful.